Coffee drinkers, what's happening? I have two things to report today. I'm kind of really excited about both of them. So the ongoing thing with my friend Gabriel that has been happening in the last two episodes of the vlog with this idea went from my little guitar Instagram thing, then he grabbed it and put his guitar on top of it. And then I heard that and thought, wow, this could be a thing. And then, you know, I did that little chord sequence in yesterday's vlog. If you haven't checked that out, check out yesterday's vlog. I've got this new chord sequence. I think I posted that vlog around midnight here, local time last night, 11:30. At 1:07 a.m., I went to bed, but I got up in the morning and I saw at 1:07 a.m., Gabriel had sent me an email. He had seen the vlog and sent me... Okay, you're not gonna... I gotta show you this. That ping was from Gabriel. Okay. That ping you just heard was from Gabriel. That was totally not planned. And I was about to turn the camera around and play you this thing that he sent me. It's not a video, it's an audio thing, but I want to get it close to the mic. And so apparently he's sending me another possible tune, which of course that just arrived. Oh man. Okay, this is, I'm really excited about this project. So now I guess I've just ruined the surprise. I think it's going to be a thing. Like I texted Gabriel today and said, hey man, how about I come out to Austin, Texas for a couple of days and we throw some ideas down on record. Like let's make this a thing. Let's see where we can go with it. We're gonna start now over the next few weeks and work on this one tune. Now he's just sent me another idea. Let's get to the thing he sent me last night. I posted a vlog 11:30. By 1:07 a.m. he had already sent me this badass chord sequence, which was kind of going off. Like he says it in the message, but it was going off. I had that bit towards the end of my chord sequence. He kind of developed that a little bit, and I think he went... I've only got that far into transcribing his thing. I have to learn all those chords, but it's awesome. But you should really hear this thing, like as he played it and as he sent it to me at like 1 o'clock in the morning, which means it was after 3 a.m. in Austin. This is like, I love this. When something starts coming together and people are into it, I don't know how excited he is about it, but I'm, as you can see, very excited about it. I just love the way his guitar sounds and like his sensibility of like voice leading and inner moving. You're gonna hear in this thing, there are these beautiful inside parts that I love. Like that really turns me on about harmony and about writing and about composition. So check out what he sent me at like 1 o'clock this morning.
Sort of related in subject to those changes you were doing. So something like that.
Those are the inner parts I was talking about.
And then he goes, I don't know, let me know what you think.
Dude, let me know what you think. I think it's awesome. So I told him that in a text earlier on, and that's when I was like, okay, let's get together. Let's really record something. Let's do something here. I can hear like a thing, a project developing, which is really fun. It's also kind of simple as well, which is amazing. Just two musicians, and we sort of have like, we both have a massive influence of Pat Metheny in our playing, and I have a huge influence of Brazilian music. It's a good connection, really good connection. And Gabriel and I have known each other for some years now as well. So it's awesome. Just got a text from Gabriel. And he's texting me now as well to check my email. Yeah, this is awesome. This is how I like to operate. So that's the one thing out of the two that I told you about that I had to report on today. The other thing is I've been listening to a lot of classical music and watching like a lot of masterclasses on YouTube with great classical musicians. And most recently with Maxim Vengerov, the violinist, Russian, Siberian violinist. And a beautiful masterclass. I'll link to it below. Check it out. It's a YouTube video. I will link to it in the description of this video. You guys can go check it out too. But it's just a thing of remembering how much I was into classical music and how much it influenced me for so long. And of course, how much I played of it on the classical guitar. I grabbed this Paganini Caprice number 24. And just with what I'm listening to a lot now with classical music and especially that Maxim Vengerov masterclass. And just tone production. And sound and time and where, you know, whereas my career and my playing and my music is so much, it's so heavily weighted with improvisation. And I've always had this concept of like most classical music it's not improvised for the most part because it's all written. But of course, you find that voice, that unique thing, that individuality in the music by finding different emotions in it. And it was great listening to Maxim Vengerov talk about that and just, you know, understanding a little better where classical musicians come from and how they find their unique voice in music that's been written hundreds of years ago in some cases, and music that's been recorded literally hundreds of times and performed tens of thousands of times all over the world. Really, really interesting to me. So it's kind of my practice routine is going in the direction of A, just wanting to improve. I think that's a huge thing. And, you know, I have good technique, I guess, and I can play some fast things. I have good control on my instrument and I'm working on my time and my sound, all that stuff. But it's I listen to these violinists and some classical musicians and understand how, what the gap is, how far away from being in control of my instrument I am when I listen to someone like Maxim Vengerov or Itzhak Perlman or Yo-Yo Ma or Evgeny Kissin, or whoever it is, there was one of these like master classical musicians. So I've kind of made it a thing to go and get back into classical music a little bit. I'm starting with this Paganini thing. I just happened to see this thing on a YouTube video. I was like, okay, it's a single note thing for the most part. There are some double stops in it, but it's a violin thing and there are very technically demanding parts of it and there are very beautiful melodic parts of it, and that will really help me concentrate on time and sound production and making emotional choices with notes that have already been chosen for me. And this is it. I've only been working on it for about an hour, trying to figure out fingerings and how I might possibly play it on this instrument that it completely wasn't written for. If you don't know this piece of music, it goes a little bit like this. And there's little things like that, things that I'm not used to phrasing wise and kind of note order or note choice wise. There's basically a five going to a one. We've got this, you could apply it to some jazz harmony, but five to one. So not only am I working on some classical things and on some sound and time and technique, but also like maybe stealing some licks from it and adding to my vocabulary. And that phrase, that descending phrase, I love the ability to move around the instrument and develop ideas. So whereas this is written, this is composed. Being in command of that and being able to play that and being able to play that completely fluently and being almost outside looking in on some aspects and then so in the middle of the music that I'm finding other emotions, it's a real big combination of things to successfully perform this kind of music. And please understand, I'm not talking from the standpoint of some classical music aficionado. In terms of what I know about classical music, it's like this, it's a quarter of 1%. In terms, I know some composers, I know some symphonies, I know what I like. now I'm really feeling like I want to dig way deeper into it than I ever have. Study it again, play it again, you know, play music from different instruments. Play. Wow, they are now drilling outside in the hallway. Gonna try not to let that be a distraction. But it was beautiful to see Maxim Vengerov's control. Like, he's giving a masterclass to these violinists, and they've obviously prepared this piece of music, and I don't know their ability and their range outside of what I've seen in this masterclass, but I'm pretty sure they've prepared like this one piece, and that's like the focus of what they're doing specifically for that masterclass. And he knows all of these pieces, and he's so in control and so relaxed that he's playing and talking, and he's talking about emotion, and he's talking about visualization, and he's talking about, you know, what you might possibly want to think about as you play certain passages. And the attitude with which he plays certain things, and he's talking about nonchalance, and he's talking about, nah, I don't care. You know, being able to play it like, oh, I don't care. I'm brilliant, but I don't care. Like, all these, you know, weird and random thoughts and feelings to have in the music to portray what the composer was trying to write in the music, what the composer was perhaps feeling at the time, whether the composer was depressed or feeling sad or feeling happy, or all of these things that come through in the writing and then have to come out in the performance and in the interpretation of that music. So it was great to be able to watch those things, get some ideas, and, you know that inspiration can come from a million different places, and this week it happens to be coming from some classical violin music and not from Pat Metheny or Michael Brecker or Herbie Hancock or any of my heroes and the people I've studied for over two decades now. So, and I have the music here up on my laptop. I want to get away from the music as quickly as possible. So I basically know the notes of that particular passage that I'm having trouble with, and there are all these articulations for the violin which don't work as well picking with the right hand with the fingers. I'm trying to, you know, get as close to them, approximate them as much as I can. This kind of which I would imagine would be a rum, some kind of bow action like that. I'll have to ask Chelsea. Violin is her first instrument, so. That's the next thing. I'm trying to do it from memory. And now we go into this sequence of also triplets and arpeggios. And I listened to it, I paced up and down my apartment for like 20 minutes listening to this on loop. Just literally walking back and forth. If someone had seen this, they would have had me committed to a mental institution. But that's just my way, pacing up and down. I do it when I'm on the phone. I do it when I'm listening to music. I pace up and down, I listen, and I start to visualize things as I'm listening to the music, which helps me remember aspects of it, the peaks and the high points and the low points and the general shape of the melody. And most of the time when I'm doing that, it's an improvisation or it's a solo, and I'm looking at the hearing and visualizing the shape of that solo. With this, it's a composed piece of music. So there are very definite shapes and angles and peaks and valleys and all of these things in it. So I did that for like 20 minutes, pacing up and down like a madman. And now it's sort of paying off. I can sort of get away from the music for the first kind of half of the first page. Those shouldn't be so disconnected. It's just a technical hitch, I guess, that I have right now because I haven't practiced it slow enough yet. And I haven't figured out what the right hand technique is going to be to execute that. Um, Whoops. So I have a lot of work to do. I think I'm going to be able to get a lot out of it, technically speaking, and musically and melodically and expressively speaking. I'm just really excited. I'm excited for two great things that happened musically today. And sometimes it doesn't happen like that. Sometimes there's a lot of time that passes between being inspired musically. And today was two great moments. So I'm really grateful to be talking to Gabriel and doing something with him and for this kind of newfound passion in classical music. Working with Gabriel, awesome. If you want to check out that documentary, that masterclass with Maxim Vengerov, that is linked below in the description of this video. The piece of music I'm working on is the Paganini Caprice number 24. It's so beautiful. I mean, wow, how do you come up with that? That's amazing. But that's my day. I hope your day is going equally as well. I hope you find some inspiration in this perhaps, or maybe you've had a moment like I've had today of your own and you're just flying with it and maybe stopping to watch the vlog on a coffee break or chicken wing break or whatever it is, candy cane break, I don't know. But today's vlog is done. I will see you guys tomorrow.